So hello and welcome to the end of day wrap. We're here at the beautiful TU International Cricket Ground. The sunglasses are on because the sun is still shining. We ended a little bit early and today is maybe the first day of really, really big upsets. Two of them potentially, if you look at the rankings, I think very much here at this ground, Saudi Arabia. Hard to call it an upset with the way they played. They were sensational. A really good bowling attack. The two openers capable of getting it up over 130 kilometers an hour, and the three spinners kept things really tight in the middle. So despite winning the toss and being inserted to bat, they could only post 216. That was Qatar. And really, with the batting surfaces the way they are here, that was never going to be enough runs on the board. And Saudi, the way they chased it down, Abdul Waheed, he put his name up in lights. It's the fifth day of the tournament. We've already had six centurions. That's the quality of cricket we're seeing here in Nepal, and also the brilliance of the cricket wickets. Four of those centuries have been here at the TU ground and two across at the Mulpani Stadium. Saudi, they cruised to victory. I asked their captain afterwards if it was the biggest win in their history. He said, yes, absolutely. And it's blown Group A wide open. It's left Singapore as the only side without a victory. In fact, Qatar is the only side without a victory in that group so far. They are played two and they have won none so far. What about over at Mulpani? It's just finished. We were watching it on the YouTube stream with our colleagues there on OSR Sports Live. It was a cracking game, and Bahrain, after a big victory in their opening match, they couldn't quite get it done and they came up just two wickets short. They couldn't defend 250 odd. They created lots of chances, but just about in the dying light over there at Mulpani, they ended up getting there by two wickets. So that means the only side without a victory in that other group, that is Singapore. So they've got it all to do right now. Where does it leave it? At the halfway stage of the group stages, it means that all is to play for. The two sides in pole position, the only two unbeaten teams, that's Nepal in Group A, and across in Group B, it is Hong Kong. Everyone else, though, very much still alive in the quest for a semi-final spot. And tomorrow feels very much like it's going to be moving day. The UAE, they have to get things back on track. They must beat Singapore here at this ground. And then over at Mulpani, who have we got? We've got Oman there taking on Malaysia. Likewise, whoever wins that game is going to be really in pole position to win and go on to the semi-finals. That's going to wrap it up for today. I think it's time to go and enjoy this beautiful sunset. Thanks so much as always for joining. Hit that subscribe button if you can as well. We'll see you tomorrow.